Welcome to Cragside, Britain's original smart home and a feat of Victorian engineering. It was created by Lord William Armstrong, an inventor, engineer and weapons manufacturer. It was a place that was created with pioneering technology to create a level of comfort and efficiency never before seen. And in the face of climate change, the renewable energy pioneered here has never been more important. Cragside is a truly unique place that has always been special to our members and visitors, and it's always been somewhere that's harnessed the power of nature. In 1863, Lord Armstrong gave a speech in which he outlined his fears about our overconsumption of fossil fuels, and he predicted that they would eventually run out. That's why here at Cragside, he experimented with the power of hydroelectricity, and why Cragside is the first place in the world to be lit using the power of water. So climate change affects all of us, but we're starting to see its impact here at Cragside, and it is one of the big threats to our ongoing ability to care for this special place and make sure that it's here for years to come. So we are in the drawing room at Cragside. This spectacular room was completed in 1884, just in time from a royal visit from the Prince and Princess of Wales. Its centrepiece is this enormous fireplace behind me. It's about 10 tons of marble and alabaster, shipped up from London to Amble and then reassembled here at Cragside. Unfortunately, the fireplace is now under threat. Increased heavy rainfall and storms are causing water to make its way into the building. That's causing the formation of salts on the surfaces of the marble and plasterwork that's starting to cause it to deteriorate. So I'm standing in one of the parapet gutters to the rear of the building. To my left is the roof of the billiard room and the drawing room is beyond that. And from here you can get a real sense of why Cragside is called Cragside. The building is literally built into the hillside. And when we get heavy downpours, the rainwater pours off of the hillside straight onto our roofs. And the guttering system here can no longer cope with that volume of water. We've commissioned an investigation to work out how we can resolve this problem and make sure that we can look after Cragside for many years to come. In 1878, Cragside became the first place in the world to be lit using hydroelectricity. In 1880, there was another world first here in the library when these lamps were lit using Joseph Swan's incandescent light bulb. Armstrong generated hydroelectricity using the artificial lakes that he created on the estate. Next, we're going to show you how we still use water power to help us light the house. In 2014, we reintroduced hydroelectricity to Cragside. Just as Armstrong did, we use water from Tumbleton Lake, just over here, to generate power. But instead of using his historic system, we now have a 17 metre long steel turbine that's just behind me, and that generates enough power to light the 350 light bulbs at the house. We have a responsibility to care for these special places, for everyone, forever, in the midst of a climate crisis that has never been more vital. Thank you for your continued support.